All right, we move ahead to our next guest, and I have to tell the story real quick. Last week, I announced on Twitter that I was joining the team here at MMA Fighting, and I was sort of blown away by all the kind words and support. And then I get a DM, and it said, "Congrats, hard work pays off," which was sent to me by the reigning Bellator Women's Featherweight Champion, Chris Cyborg, who joins us on the program right now. Chris, how are you?
I'm great. Thank you. Congratulations again. Very nice.
Thank you.
I'm
very
really
much.
Happy. Enjoy your show. Thanks for having me here.
Absolutely. Thank you for that message. That really meant a lot. And my first question, of course, with everything going on around the country and around the world, how are you and everyone around you doing in the midst of this coronavirus pandemic?
You know, staying home all day, you know, and then I started my YouTube doing training, workout with my fans. If we can do and do something in the mornings, you know. Make it then put stress out. I think it's very important. I think it's a time for you really think about and enjoy your family, pray. This is my day doing.
It's kind of interesting because it's a very surreal time in the world right now. We've seen viruses and illnesses sort of create havoc. But, you know, in my lifetime, and I'm a couple of years older than you are, I can't remember anything even close to what's going on right now. What have you sort of learned about yourself and about the world as this has been playing out?
You know, I feel like you're nothing. What's happening? You know, it's nothing. Like you can be rich, you can be poor, you can happen with you. Like we nobody, and it's a kind of sad. But I think it's a lot of people think it's the same way, you know. And but you know, I cannot be afraid. I think we have a lot of things going on in our life, and thank you. Just have faith, and we're gonna pass through everything. But the most important, don't forget to wait pass through. I think it's the most important because for sure this day is gonna change our lives for better. You know, we have to forget about today.
Right. 2020 has been a sort of an auspicious start, and 2019 was sort of a roller coaster year for you, wasn't it, Chris? I mean, you were coming off your first loss in over a decade. You wanted that rematch with Amanda Nunes. You end up fighting Felicia Spencer. You got the win there, and all this while you're having sort of this big issue with the UFC and Dana White. And then months later, you signed with Bellator for only fighting once last year. That had to have been one of the more emotional years of your fighting career, was it not?
No, it's crazy, you know. I think I have a great moment in UFC. I have a bad moment, you know. It's like life. One day is good, another day is bad, you know. But I'm really thankful, you know. I think bad things happen, but for a reason. You know, I learned a lot from that fight. I learned a lot from the person and the athlete. And I was like to improve. I was never thinking my life I was not going to lose again. Just I lost my first fight. And I know this can come. No, but because as I train always hard for my fights, you know, I do the best inside the cage and the gym and do my best over there and leave it God's hands. He's take care of that.
When you got that Bellator contract and you finally put pen to paper, can you describe what that felt like after everything you had gone through? Was it a huge weight lifted off of your shoulders?
You know, I was happy and then feel like everything, you know, everything I passed through learning, you know, lesson. You know, if I don't pass, I was never know. And I think the one thing is, I think being in UFC opened the door for having my division there. If I never try, it's never going to be there. You know, and signing with Bellator, I think can open the eyes a lot of fighters. You know, you can see having other places too. And they're going to appreciate the fighters. And the example of, you know, Bellator canceled the fight because of coronavirus. And all the fighters getting paid about this. You know, and this is just for people open their eyes. I think it'd be example. I like to be example for a lot of people and change people's lives.
Obviously, you don't have to drop any names or anything like that. But since all this has happened, since you've signed over with Bellator, have you had fighters from your division or other people on the UFC roster reach out to you and ask about whether the grass is greener over there?
Yes, they say, you know, then now some people say, okay, I'm going to wait my contract finish. You know, because the one thing I did, I wait for my contract finish, you know, for me to see the option. Because in the beginning, they say you don't value anything. But if you don't go looking for stuff, how's you going to know? You know, and a lot of people say, how's the work over there? Then treat the fighters nice, how's the work? And the first thing you have is freedom, you know, I can fight. I can do boxing fight if I want. I can do WWE. I can wear any clothes I want to the fight. I can wear a uniform. I can have a sponsor I want to wear for me, be thankful for my sponsors. I think it's different. You know, it's very different. The defense can see the style of the fighter. You know, it's hard when everybody wants to use the same uniform.
Do you think we may see you in Bellator or boxing or WWE this year? I know there's a lot going on, so it's really hard to put a time frame on all of that stuff. But if things sort of get back to normal, like we hope it will, do you see yourself diving into those different things this year?
You know, before the coronavirus, I have a plan maybe next fight to go a boxing fight. You know, I'm really training a lot and learning a lot. I know it's a different sport, but I'm very happy and excited. And you know, this is, I think, going to be my next step. I think my career, I have 4 different tires, you know, all good in the organization, MMA. And maybe, you know, maybe if I I'm training and getting prepared and wait for the opportunity coming. Let's see what's going to happen after the coronavirus.
You mentioned winning your 4th world title. You did so against Julia Budd in January. You finished the fight in the 4th round. You've won lots of fights. You've won lots of world titles throughout your career. Where would you rank that night at Bellator 238?
No, I was quite happy. I was quite really happy. Be really thankful to be there. And God's so amazing. They put me in the same place I lost my title. And I fought there again and got my title again. You know, it's another organization, but it's the same symbol, you know. And just thankful. I was happy. I trained really hard for hours. I trained for the fight and feel prepared and feel happy, you know, feel welcome where I'm at, you know. And all the support, my fans, they're there with me. They follow me. This is nice, Cyber Nations, because they follow me where I'm going. They like to watch my fights. They watch my personality. And this is just making me very thankful for them.
And to share the cage with somebody like Julia Budd, who's been so successful, you know, one of the best 145-pound fighters in the world. What was that like for you to not only just get a victory over her, but share that experience and share that cage time with her?
No, she's the real 145-pound, you know, and she's 8 years undefeated, you know, and she's long time fighting, the real 145-pound champion. And for me, it's a great honor to fight her. You know, I think she's doing amazing in our division. And she don't quit. She keep doing, you know, her 45-pound. And I always fight for the division growing. And in Bellator, one thing, I have a lot of girls in my division over there. You know, I can fight more times per year. And this make me happy than fight just one time per year and make me active and fight and train all the time.
You talked about Scott Coker paying the fighters after that event got canceled last month. On the other side of things, Dana White has really prodded the media. He's called us weak and wimpy for, you know, maybe wanting to see these shows being canceled. But I think it's more because we don't want to see fighters get sick. We want to see the fighters be healthy and continue on with their careers. Now, from a fighter's perspective, I understand why fighters want to fight. And in a lot of cases, I understand why they need to fight. This isn't like other sports. So seeing how Dana's handled everything and seeing how Scott's handled it, if you were the boss, if you were the promoter here, how would you handle the situation?
You know, the difficulty for us, the fighters, we make money when we fight, you know, and especially UFC. UFC, it's hard to have a sponsor because you can have a sponsor, but it's hard. You cannot put you when you fight your clothes. You know, you have to just help them social media. And how is it going to pay your bills if you don't fight, you know? I understand we have a very hard time now because the coronavirus, everybody don't work now. But if you then cancel the fight and the people training for the fight, they have to pay your fighters. They use the money you have for pay your coaches, for pay your camp. We're supposed to make the person, the fight purse, for sure. You know, and I'm really happy. When Bellator did this, I say, man, I'm in the right place. You know, I'm thankful. You know, I choose the right place. Then you appreciate the fighters. They know the fighters make the event happen, you know, and very nice attitude. For sure, they lose money too, you know, but at this point, everybody losing money, you know, everybody, you know, and but you think about the next one, you know, your neighbor. It's not a lot of people do. And this is the difference to be at Bellator.
You're trying to help out during these crazy times by hosting the live boot camp style classes during the week on your YouTube page. What inspired that idea?
You know, I was going to be home anyways. And I said, you know, I'd like to work out a little bit at the house and I go crazy. And And then we have the idea, why you don't do life, you know, for the fans too? You know, for me, one thing, when I'm very stressed or no good mood, I like to train, you know, for your stress out. Release the stress. And then we start doing it, and then the people, you know, really enjoy, really send the message and like. And today is supposed to be the last day. And but we make a plan for being with the fans. But if the guys are watching now would like to do the workout, they have 8 classes we did during the week. And we're going to think about one day, 2 times a week for you continue doing after this. You know, I think it's nice. Change life, you know, then stay home, then can train it, then can train with me, pray, be thankful, be your fan, you know, with your family. It's cool.
What's been your favorite part of doing these videos?
See, the, you know, it's, I never did video training like this. This is the first time for me. I was kind of a little nervous, but I say, you know, it's, they don't know who I am, it's going to be, but then this, then we'll enjoy. They really like, they say, I cannot believe Chris doing this workout with us. You know, I try doing Portuguese and English. You can see that for making the people in Brazil happy too. They can train too. And for me making me another thing, I have the pink belt fitness, the girls training together at the camp. But now I think you'll be home and the people is very nice. And they're going to continue doing this. I think this is nice.
For those who are watching this and are new to the sport and new to combat sports, and I think your fight with Gina Carano is one everyone should go back and watch. It's such an underrated fight when it comes to the evolution of women's MMA. But for the new fans, because I know a lot of fans are asking for suggestions on fights to go back and watch from the past, what fights would you recommend, whether it be fights you've been involved with or a fight that you're fond of?
I think you can watch Gina Carano. I think it's the first fight at the title for 145 pounds. I think it's a great fight. And but I think I have a lot of fights in my career. It's epic. I think it then, but I think Gina Carano is a good one for then start following me. After that fight, everybody said, the killer machine, it's crazy. I think that fight is going to be good. And then it's going to be, that fight makes the people addictive.
A couple more things before we let you go. I appreciate the time very much. I'd be remiss if I didn't ask you about your former colleague, John Jones. You've shared a couple of cards with him. We saw him in the news once again last week, and you know he's arrested on several charges. When you saw that news, how did you react to it?
I feel upset. You know, I think I have to pray for him. You know, for me, it's really nice with him when I meet him, talk to him. Sounds nice guy, and have to pray for him. I know it's very hard time for the family, you know, and for make change, you know. I think it's going to be hard, pray for him, very upset.
Yeah, it's a crazy situation. And in terms of everybody else that's watching this right now, you're a very positive person. You're lighting up the room with the smile here. What's the message to everyone out there, from fans to fellow fighters to anyone watching around the world? What's the message for everybody as we look to get past this chaotic time in the world?
I just want to say thank you, guys, for all the love you guys sent to me, and say I'm praying for you guys. Don't be afraid. Don't be scared. This is the one more battle we're going to go through. And make sure to pray, open your heart for your God, and you know, for He protect you, be with you, you know, for everything is going to happen. And don't forget about this time, you know, because this time maybe have for you, change me, you know, change us for appreciate a lot of things we have. And that's it. I'm going to pray for you and be positive. Think about the bad things happen, but having one reason and have the good things going to come. I know it's a hard time to see that time. That's it. I'm going to pray for you guys and pray for you for we pass through together and be strong. And I'm going to show you, Manny.
Yeah.
What's Manny?
Yes.
Manny. Show my meal, Peggy. Okay, so one minute. Manny, come here, Manny. Say hi. Say hi.
Oh my God. That is the best.
This is Manny. Manny Pacquiao. They say hello from everyone.
Manny Pacquiao? That is amazing.
Manny Pacquiao.
How long has Manny Pacquiao been a part of the family?
I think it'll be almost 1 year and a half. 1 year and a half. Yes. It's good patch. Very nice.
Was that a plan or did you happen to just stumble upon the Manny and say, I have to have him?
I know I love pets, and I have 2 cats. I have Feather, my dog, and then now I like different animals. I say, no, I want to get a pig. And then funny because everybody at the house say, every fight you're gonna bring one different pet. Like, Chris, this fight, no pets, no pets. They have more pets than people at the house. And what's funny, sometimes I got him in Google. I see about pets, and then I go Google mean pig, and then I got it. Then I'm glad he stay mini, you know, he's not too big. But he's sweet, sweet, very sweet pet.
How does Manny get along with the cats and the dog? Are they getting along great, or is there a little ruckus from time to time?
The beginning, my cats want to attack him. All the time, we see the cats in his butt, like bite his leg, and then we always save him. But now they're friends. They're friends. They play together. It's very cool.
That's great. Chris, thank you so much for doing this. Like I said, getting that message meant a lot, and it means a lot that you would join us for our debut show here. All the best to you, your family, and your loved ones, and thank you again for the time. Hopefully, we get to see you back in there sooner rather than later, but obviously, there's more important things than fighting right now.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. Follow me, my YouTube channel, Chris Borg, and I'm gonna be new for Enjoy Twitch. Twitch, follow me and start to play games together. And yes, let's be together more and more we can. Thank you.
That's great. Thank you, Chris.